Hey everybody, all right, I'm right about to head out, but I want to just say over the next few days, I'm gonna bring you along with me around Singapore and we are going to experience all the craziness that the F1 weekend has to offer in Singapore. There is so much going on in town right now. There is not just F1, there's also a massive crypto conference going on, Token 2049. And then on top of that, there's actually a private equity VC conference and a few other things going on. So over the last couple of days, there has been thousands of people that flew into Singapore for all these amazing things. And I'm so excited to bring you along with me because I'm gonna be going to a bunch of side events and parties. So I will caveat, I didn't buy tickets to go watch the actual F1 race itself, but I did get invited to some events where I will be catching the race from a different view. And I'm just so excited, okay? There's so many cool people in town. And honestly, everything that you associate with Singapore F1 weekend, okay? All the glamour, all the bouginess, you're gonna see all of that in this video, especially because on Sunday, I'm actually gonna go to Amber Lounge. And so I'd expect nothing but bouginess when you go there. So let's head out and I'm gonna bring you guys along with me. Let's go. So first things first, I'm gonna go visit the Token 2049 conference. I have a few friends that are super into crypto, so I'm gonna go pay them a visit. One of them got me a ticket. Thank you, David. So I would love to check it out. It's actually almost near the end of the day, so I'm sure it's not as vibing as it was earlier today, but all the fun stuff happens at night anyway. So, all right, we are pulling up at Marina Bay Sands, and I'm pretty sure there's just like 18 million road closures, but I'm really happy that I managed to get dropped off here. I should say that to you. Welcome to Singapore, my friend.
Welcome to crypto.
Oh. Facts. Thank you. Thank you for the for the ticket. He's my tour guide for today.
So we're going to go up and it's just going to be a conference hall.
Okay.
And that's it.
So I just said bye to David real quick because before I go to the first event of the day, I really want to run an errand and pick up a new iPhone because the phone that I'm using to film this right now is my iPhone XR. I've been using this phone for 10 years now and my battery life is absolute garbage and I really want to get a phone with a better camera quality. And there is the iconic Apple Store here. Let me show you. You may have seen this before. This is the floating ball and it is the Apple Store and it's so beautiful. So I'm just gonna go see if they have anything in stock, which I really, really, really hope they do, but look at how lovely it is here. All right.
So we still have the 13 Pro Max 1TBs left.
I am devastated. They are all sold out, which I shouldn't be surprised about, but I thought for some reason, because the Apple Store isn't entirely packed with people, that they would have enough stock, but they don't. And I really wanted to use my new phone camera to film this, like the next few days without having to bring a camera around. So I'm gonna have to find a way around that. Anyway, I might just place an order online. But in the meantime, look at how amazing this Apple Store is. I'm at the mall, I figured I'm just gonna go walk around and shop a little bit because I want to go see if I can pick up some funky new black boots. I really want to pick up a fun pair of shoes that are comfortable without having to wear heels. So I'm really loving my outfit today. Hello! And I love these boots. I've had them for like 5-6 years. They've seen me through a lot and these boots have traveled a lot, but they're starting to break. So I'm gonna go to Charles and Keith and see what cool shoes they have. Ooh, I like these. Yes, this is my section right here. I really love these like chunky orange black boots. There's also one more style I really wanted to try on, but I don't see where it is. I also wanted to try on these ones right here, which I think are quite nice as well.
A few moments later.
Guys, the boots that I wanted to buy, the ones that I came to the store to try on, are out of stock as well. What is up with everything being out of stock today? Do we like these boots? Do they look too similar to my other ones? Like, I like how chunky they are actually. These are the other options. Quite like these ones actually even more. I think these are actually really flattering. And they're quite comfortable. Say hello. Do you want to come in the mirror?
Yes.
Hello. So she's joined me on my boot hunting journey, and her boots are from Zara as well. Show me that fit. Yes. All right. I'm going to find a place to try this on. We discovered another pair of shoes.
Oh, they're tight, but they're cute.
Why is every boot I like out of stock in my size?
Oh, I love them. They're cute.
Where are your boots?
I think they're vibing it.
No.
Oh, they look like rain boots.
Yeah.
No.
No. I like
it. Actually, should we just buy them?
Yeah, look, they're so cute.
I don't think there's enough black boots here. We found the boots. And now we can get ready and head out to the event that we're actually supposed to do.
Priorities.
Accurate. This is a self-care routine. Stop. Stop. Oh my god. Living your best life. He's like, no, I want to get out of here. Oh no, 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 no. How's your subway? We're in such a rush. Love, look at our black boots. Worth?
Who's a good boy?
Sega.
We love a bougie and fabulous, but make it economical.
Debating if we want to just go home and
go
rest.
Watch some Korean
dramas. God, Sega.
Look at these little toes.
This is adulting. Come back from a party,
yeah.
Just to hang out with a dog. It's
gonna
be so. No ears.
And a spoiled little dog.
So cute. Oh, you're so cute.
As you can tell by my work attire at the top and pajama pants at the bottom, last night I actually didn't get home very late. I think I slept at around 1 in the morning, which is really not bad considering evening festivities and parties. But this morning I had such a difficult time waking up, and so I let myself sleep in a bit, and I quite literally just rolled out of bed and took my first meeting not long ago. Usually on Fridays I like to go cycling in the morning. Obviously that didn't happen, but it's also because no one else I know is cycling today or the next few days, and it's kind of a write-off for everyone since there's so much F1 evening stuff happening, and so that's fine. But just because it's F1 weekend doesn't mean that there's no work. So this morning I'm gonna take all my video calls. I'm gonna just do some not very fun email, accounting, a lot of ops stuff I need to do. So for now, I'm gonna just spend the next couple hours being a hermit at home, getting some work done. And then later half of today is gonna be all the social stuff. So I'm still waiting to play by ear on like if I wanna go to this one F1 party tonight. But honestly, I'm quite tired, so I think I need to like pace myself. But we'll see what happens. For now, let's get some work done. It is lunchtime. Oh, I was feeling so lazy, and also I haven't done groceries yet, so it is time for frozen dumplings. So I'm just mixing everything up. It's actually 3 p.m. so my eating schedule is a little bit wacky today, but I need to quickly finish this lunch, and I'm gonna get ready for I'm gonna get ready for the afternoon slash evening. I don't know what my schedule is gonna be like. I'm really playing everything by ear. Also, I wanna see how my energy is like. And I might try to squeeze in running an errand. I don't know, I haven't figured it out yet. And then later tonight, after my friend's birthday dinner, everyone else is going out and about because it's a Friday night and there's so many things going on. There's a marshmallow concert as part of F1. There's also the Mandala Weekender, which is this thing organized by a social club in Singapore called Mandala. And it's like every day, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, there's a party going on at the bottom, I think the basement level of Marina Bay Sands, the mall. And so that is a huge event that a lot of people are going to. Tickets for that are usually, I think, like a couple $100. I wasn't gonna go to it, but my friend, she's lovely, Carmen, she was like, hey, got an extra ticket, do you wanna come? I was like, ah! So we'll see. I might need to come home a few times just to get ready and drop off stuff, because can't go straight from a work event. Like, I won't be dressed to go out at night to go party, so we'll see what happens. But for now, we just worry about what's happening for the next 10 minutes, and I'm just gonna eat. I just finished getting ready. My makeup is done. My hair, I'm just gonna leave in a bun for now, because I will be coming back home later, but for now I'm going to a work shenanigan thing and a birthday dinner. So I was thinking of wearing, oh let me just show you, yes, also I'm standing on top of a ladder. This is the outfit I'm planning on wearing. I wore this white blazer yesterday, but I'm really loving this white on white on white kind of vibe, and I'll probably do black boots. I'm gonna go quickly run an errand first, and then I'm gonna head towards the first event of the evening. Let's go. It is Friday, late afternoon, and it is popping everywhere in Vivo City right now. I just had to quickly pick something up at Vivo, but now I am once again getting onto the subway, and I'm gonna head towards where all the crazy traffic is. So all around the F1 track, everything is closed, all the roads are closed. So actually these few days, to be honest, the best way of getting around Singapore truly is public transport, especially stuff that's underground. So that's why I keep using buses and stuff. Also because like there's so many people in town, the price of taxis and grabs and gojeks are like astronomical. So ain't nobody paying three times the price for like a 3 kilometer ride. So I'm gonna take the subway. It requires a little bit more walking, but that's fine because I dressed very comfortably. It's super crazy. So from here, you can see like a segment of the track, and there's so many people trying to catch a glimpse of it. Super cool. But I would love to catch it, but I gotta go to my event, and I think the event itself is actually intended for us to be able to watch it from
above, so I need to get to my thing.
Alright, so the event I'm going to right now, it's not a crypto event, it is hosted by Carta. And so they're on the 20th floor. I'm excited.
Yeah, hello.
Show me the views. Oh shoot, shut up. That's such a great view.
Let's just wait for a car.
You can see like all the people on the overhead passage. What a great view.
Yeah.
I'm sure they'll continue.
So this is our new logo.
Plug it. Plug Carta. What's Carta? Tell me.
We are your source of truth for equity. So if you really, you say you brand yourself as a source of infrastructure for innovators.
Love it. Is that the new tagline or was it always that?
So we are like a platform now. And basically this is like a building block.
Love it. Smile. It is almost 9 p.m. I stayed a lot longer than I had intended because it's such a great event. Actually, I really, really enjoyed it, for real. But I need to go to my friend's birthday dinner. So, but I do want to say bye to Ben and go downstairs and also say bye to Jay and Vanessa. All these people ready to watch the practice round on Friday. Love that you can watch it from here. Honestly, I'm so happy I got to see a little bit of the cars from the view from the hotel. So the Carta event just now was at the presidential suite of Park Royal Hotel Marina Bay. So it was like the perfect location. It was so great. Like hearing the cars was just like, it makes my heart pound. Also, I would love to actually properly go to the race one year. All right, you guys, we're gonna manifest this, okay? One year. Let's try to get like some super kick-ass tickets to go see F1 anywhere in the world. I don't care where it is. All right, so this street over here is one of my favorite streets in Singapore. It's called Keong Saik, and there are tons of bars and tons of amazing restaurants here. You'll see that there's a lot of people sitting outside. So the place I'm going to is Potato Head, which is this awesome looking building right here. It's got a really lovely rooftop and I can hear my friends at the top already. These stairs are the bane of my existence. Hello! Hi birthday girl! This is Jasmine! Hello! Just left. It is 10 o'clock now. I didn't stay for very long, but I did get to wish Jasmine a happy birthday. All of them are heading out as well because they're all going to the Marshmallow concert, which is happening as part of F1. But I'm gonna be going to the Mandala Weekender, so I'm just gonna head home right now and get changed. All right, I just got ready in literally record-breaking time, under 10 minutes, and I'm heading back out again. Back at the exact same subway station I was at 20 minutes ago, but we are almost there. Made it on time.
Singapore things just upgrade to VIP for $1,500.
2 in the morning right now, and I've been wanting to leave since like an hour ago, but I kept bumping into friends, so I kept just saying hi. And as you can tell, my voice is so raspy right now, but I am finally leaving and going home. The music wasn't my usual type of music, so I wasn't like going all out, and I figured I still have Saturday and Sunday, which I'm really excited for, so I just want to call it a night and rest up and pace myself for the weekend. So anyway, I will see you guys bright and early tomorrow morning. See you later. Good night.
Oh my god, I've been waiting for a Grab slash taxi slash Gojek slash Tada for like 15 minutes now, and there's just no car picking me up.
All right, good morning everybody. As you can tell, I'm in my athletic wear because I am right about to go out for a very chill ride. It's very late right now, and I definitely slept in, and I cannot remember the last time I slept in until 11 in the morning, okay? So last night, I actually ended up sleeping at 5:30 in the morning because I bumped into more friends and people that I know. So this morning, I was just very tired. I slept in. But I've got a brunch very soon, and I am going to go... Sorry, I'm just like trying to French braid my hair right now. I am going to go cycle there because it's actually just along the river. It's near Fullerton Hotel, which is actually where all the F1 madness is. So I have no idea where I'm going to park my bike. I'm hoping that I can park it in one of the car parks down below, but let's see what happens. All right, so I don't usually like sleeping in until like as late as 11 because I feel like the whole day is already gone, but that's okay. Every once in a while, we will just let loose and relax. It was funny because when I said I was going to film this F1 weekend video, I asked you guys what you wanted to see on Instagram, and someone wrote, we want to see you enjoy the weekend without thinking or doing work. That is impossible, okay? Because also, I guess that's how I know I really like what I'm doing, because I actually really miss being able to sit down on my laptop for an uninterrupted like 6 hours just to get some work done, which that is actually what I'm going to do later. So after brunch, I've actually got a angel investor meeting, and then I've got another meeting with a friend who's visiting town for the crypto conference, and then I'm gonna go home. So I'm really excited because tonight I did not make any plans. I'm gonna probably just stay at home after my meetings and get some work done, and I'm so excited because I just want to like cross some things off my to-do list. So I'm so excited. Anyway, I'm gonna head out. See you guys on the road. All right, the old Black Panther bike. Look at this baby. Haven't ridden it in a while, so I figured I'd take it out for a nice little spin.
So I raced over here, but I forgot to account for the fact that it is closed because it's for people who have F1 tickets. So I'm gonna try to find a detour another way. Let's see how I can get to Fullerton Hotel.
All the road closures, but I think I found my way here. So I'm just gonna cross over here and then try to bring my bike up to the restaurant.
Hello, thanks for waiting for me. Oh my gosh, we're gonna try to see if they let us bring in my bike. Yeah, work your charm, please. Yes, girl, yes.
Hello!
What'd you order?
I ordered the salmon Benedict. I'm so excited.
Wow. Oh, cool. Alright, time to eat.
And even the 14 is even
better. I'm borrowing her phone, and the cinematic mode is so beautiful.
I've never made it out.
Oh. Why is this kettle so perfect? Oh man, I should not have ridden my bike, but there were no clouds earlier when I checked the rain map. Oh, what am I gonna do? Gonna try to wait for the rain to pass. I'm trying to move my meetings to the same cafe now. Let's hope it is okay. How chaotic is this? You literally can't see anything behind, like in the video, or maybe my quality is just too bad.
All right, it stopped raining, but I'm just gonna do my next meeting here and say bye.
Bye.
I just finished my meeting with Jonathan, and I'm just gonna take my laptop out and get a little bit of work because I've got a another meeting in around half an hour. So I'm just gonna park myself here because it's still looking a little bit gloomy outside. So I'm actually feeling a little bit heated. Like, I don't know if I'm about to get a fever or what. It's not feeling great, very low energy. Maybe I just need to sleep. So I'm gonna call it a night. I'm gonna cycle home. And yeah, I'll just take it easy. There are so many people lining up to go inside right now, but the lines are moving really quick. So so right now it's just an afternoon. I'm dressed very casually because I'm just gonna run a few errands. I want to make a donation for some clothes, and then I'm gonna go pick up some meds for both myself and my friend who's not feeling well and drop off a little care package. I want to go buy something as well for tonight, and then gonna go home, finish getting some stuff done, and then we'll get ready for a very fun evening. My lovely solo table for one. Alright, getting pho because I'm not feeling that great, so I want to just get something soupy, and then I'm gonna finish running my errands in a bit. Got the goods, just picked up some stomach medicine, something for a sore throat.
Alright, hello. Just got home not long ago. It is now 5:30 at night. I'm just gonna chill at home and get some work done because I've got a really important meeting tomorrow and it's already Sunday. And yeah, I'm gonna have like a dinner at home, and I might still go out a little bit earlier to go catch the F1 race from one of the buildings where you can see it from above. But my friend is gonna go and let me know how the vibe and situation is, because unless it's like super amazing, honestly, I might just catch it live at home on a stream and get a few more hours of just like alone, chill downtime before I have to head out for Ember Lounge, which I'm really stoked for. So I want to just make sure I'm well rested. Yeah, so gonna get some work done and have a little bit of my pre-cut pineapples. Hello everybody, it is 9:30 at night. Yeah, 9:30 at night right now, and I'm still in my glasses and PJs because I didn't end up going to go to the building to go watch the F1 race from above. The race was actually delayed by an hour as well because it was torrential rain earlier,
And so now they are racing, but I'm just deep in my Excel sheets because I'm actually doing some financial modeling right now. So I'm actually quite glad that I stayed at home. Gotta finish another maybe like half an hour of work, then I'm gonna start getting ready, which sounds wild to say because it's gonna be close to 10 p.m. But I'm gonna start getting ready in a bit and actually set up my ring light because I am going to film a quick little TikTok video slash Instagram reels. For now, I'm gonna go back to listening to my house music while I continue working. Got like my Excel sheet on one half of the screen and the F1 streaming on the other half. Just got home and it is now 2:30 in the morning. It's actually not as late as I thought it would be, to be honest, because considering the fact that I got to the venue at like 12:30 in the morning, it's only been like 2 hours, and my friend Carmen and I went there together because she was the one that invited me, which I'm very grateful for. Carmen is amazing. And we only stayed for 2 hours and we left because honestly, I don't know, let me backtrack. For those who don't know, Amber Lounge is like the official after party for F1 all around the world. And so it's a big deal. It's super exclusive. It's super expensive as well. So I was very grateful that I got invited by my friend to go. But honestly, if you wanted to get a table there, I think it starts at 15 grand and it goes like, there's table that's starting from $40,000 and above. I'm just not the type of person that would ever do that. But to each their own, right? However, I will say, if I were one of those people that spent that much money and the music that they played was what they played tonight, I'd be so upset because honestly, it was not that great. So I don't know, maybe I don't want to get like shat all over for having this opinion because I'm sure a lot of people will have fun. Just wasn't my cup of tea, okay? Disclaimer. I do think it was worth going once just to experience what it's like, and I'd be down to go to other Amber Lounge parties around the world, but yeah, I just wasn't really vibing the one in Singapore this year. It was a great way to end the fabulous weekend, and so even though it is 2:30 in the morning, I did want to jump on here and just say thank you guys so much for watching until the end. And if you are watching right now, scroll down, leave a comment, and tell me which is your favorite F1 driver and racing team. I'd love to know who is your favorite. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. If you want to keep up to date in the meantime about just what I get up to day to day, here's my Instagram, my TikTok, my Facebook, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!